Hey guys, this is Hawkeye and I am back with another episode of Fishing Planet, and this is the first episode for season 4. We are starting off with a regular everyday mission of some form, but basically this has been a challenge. I don't know if it's really considered a challenge. Actually, this is more like, would you show me what you can do with these things? Kind of like them. Anyway, I had somebody, one of my viewers, ask if I could show how some of the new lures and things can be used at some of the earlier maps, like Texas, Mudwater, that type of thing. So that's what we're doing here, guys. We are here at Mudwater. I figured I'd go ahead and start off with one that's pretty been around a while, just to see just what you can do with these new lures. I haven't really tried that many of them. I have tried one of them though for sure, and that's the nano spinners. But there are other ones that have been added as well, like the runners, and so we're going to see what we can do here with these. Just give it a try. Anyway, guys, I have quite a variety here in my inventory as far as things go. I've got 7 rods that I am carrying with me, and that basically opens up a lot of options here. I can bottom fish, top fish, cast, spin, whatever I want to do, and I try to keep it that way. But some of these can be replaced with other types of rods and earlier rods. You don't have to use these big monsters, some of which I've got, like this Sala monster. That was one I had purchased quite some time ago for Canique Creek, and I use it for the big fish. I also like to use it because it handles really large lures as well. The same goes for this Mary Tree. That was a Christmas special from a couple Christmases ago. But we can still show off some of those special lures here, guys. But let me go ahead and show you here. I've got this, honestly, it's called a Jolly Jerkbait. And this is one that came from the Christmas special last time. But it'll do just as well as any of the jerkbaits that you can purchase. I haven't purchased any yet, but they work just as good. I also got a Merry Runner, which works the same as some of the runners do. This is a 19-foot. This may be a little on the deep side, so we may end up having to switch off and get a smaller one for that. I don't know if I've got one on hand here. Yes, I do. Actually, we might just go ahead and switch that to the 13 arrows deep here. Maybe that'll be a little... See, this is a little bit finer. It's not as heavy. And here I've got on my Featherlight a nano spinner. It's a Jolly nano spinner, but any of the nano spinners would work. I'm also going to try a mini bass jig, just so we can get kind of a well-rounded look at what you can fish with here. There's all kinds of things here we can try. Some are new, some have been around a little bit, or not used as often by people, I believe. But let's go ahead and start with this Jolly Jerkbait. Now, this is the reason I'm starting off with this one is because I'm the least familiar with this one. I have not tested this one here at all, so this one's going to be new for me too, and we're going to see what we can do with it here, guys. All right, we're going to go ahead and go fishing. We're going to have to advance time quite a bit though, because we're nowhere even close to the peak time. But anyway, we're here in the peak. And we're going to try this Merry Runner or this Jolly Jerkbait and see if these guys go for it. Now, like I said, I have not fished with these yet, so this is going to be new for me. I'm going to try a couple of presentations, but it is a sinking lure, so we're going to set it to 2. Start there. It takes a while to sink, so maybe you have to reel it in a little bit. Now, yeah, you do, apparently. Now, I did have somebody else challenge me to catch a 70-pound tarpon. Well, guys, the tarpon don't come that big unless you catch the terror tarpon. And the terror tarpon I caught in the Halloween special was 77 pounds. So I've already done that, if that's the case. Another challenge I was given was to catch catfish with topwater lures. Now, I'm not so certain they go for topwater lures. I mean, I've checked and they go for crawls and a few other things, but usually they're on the bottom too, guys. So I don't know that that's one we can actually do. But I'm trying to stop and go here, and it's not really reacting very well. So maybe we have to do a twitch with this one. Now it's getting a good stop and go. This is a very, very big hook on here, so 6-aught is pretty darn good size for this level of a fishery or lake. I think we're gonna do kind of a popping action here. It's not really gonna be popping, it's gonna be twitching. Let's do a little faster. All right, I'll be honest, guys. I've tried a few times here and not so much as a nibble on it. Kind of thinking it's just too big of a hook, to be honest. I don't think it's the lure necessarily. This would probably work someplace like the Everglades, but trophy bass here are far and few in between. That's pretty much the only thing that could probably take it down. Maybe one of those snake heads or bowfin, but other than that, I don't think you're going to get a whole lot of activity off of this. At least not here. Now, where I have tried, it has been the Everglades, and they did bite off of it. And as a matter of fact, the trophy bass go for it about every time. But yeah, it's not doing much of anything here, guys. So I think we're going to switch over here to our 13 arrows deep runner. Now, this is a 3-aught hook, so it's a little more reasonable. Now, this is one that you just reel in slowly. We're going to give this a try, see if anything might go for it. I have no idea. This is a very shallow river, so 19 foot's going to put it right near the bottom. I do it at one notch because I like to reel these in slow. Moose Lake, the Atlantic salmon will hit these, and so the lake trout. Kind of interested to see if anything will go for it here. Yeah, I think a lot of those new lures, guys, to be perfectly honest, are for other lakes. All right, guys, let's try one more lure here in this particular location. Make sure I have it already set up here. I don't, so I'm gonna go ahead and put it in. Let's see. This is another Merry Runner, but it's a much smaller one. And we're going to see how it does. This is probably a good size for this lake. But the runners, I would say a 2-aught hook or less. Now, I'm not the biggest fan of the crawls or the worms or all that stuff. A lot of people are really into those. I am more of a spoon spinner type of guy. Well, there we go. We got a bite, guys. There you go. The young largemouth bass went for the runner, Merry Runner. That's good to know. Now, I haven't gotten any bites so far off of anything else, but that did get me one. I was thinking because of the size, we would have a better chance. That 6-aught one, I'm not saying it won't happen, I'm just saying it'd be so hard. Because these guys just are the, you need a trophy to be able to get it. And They're far, like I said, far and few in between. Do a little bit of fishing over here. I want to try some of the other ones that I tried before. Not that. There we go. I am determined to see if this anything will go for this, but I'm just not convinced the bowfin won't go for it, but I mean, I may be wrong. Just not going for it, guys. They're just not going for it. Let's try the deep runner. Since we're in catfish territory, you never know. I've not seen anything about catfish going for deep runners, but they do go for some lures, especially the bigger ones. Now this is going to go way to the bottom and probably drag right along the bottom. This has got a huge hook, so it's only going to get a catfish or a bowfin. Or possibly nothing at all. Alright, let's try it again. And then we'll try the one that's a little bit smaller. Well, not gotten one hit off of that. So far, the only thing that they've hit on has been the Merry Runners. So they're 19 feet. They're a little bit bigger as far as body goes. So they look more like a fat fish. Smaller hook. So it's a good possibility that these are one that you can use probably for both here in Texas. Yep. This is definitely a good lure for this location. But so far I've only gotten young largemouth bass off of it. So whether it gets more than that, I'm not certain. I think what we're going to do is we're going to jump one more time here. Over down it. Well, that's not what I wanted to hit. I think what we're going to do is jump one more time over here to Pike Challenge. I am going to see if the pike might go for it, so we're going to take it right where they are. If I get another young largemouth bass, I think that's pretty much what this guy goes for. And there we got something. All right. And the pike do go for it. There's a chain pickerel. Nice one. Now these Merry Runners are very, like I said, they're very similar to some of the other heavy-bodied runners. And I had a lot of luck with the chain pickerel at Emerald Lake as well with them, as well as the walleye. Now, so far, like I said, haven't been able to get the jerk baits to do squat. So I don't know if they're going to do you any good here, guys. Seems like they just don't really go for those skinny bodied deep runners here. Not sure why that is. It's just the species doesn't prefer it, I guess. But we're going to see if we get any activity from the pickerel. No, there we go, guys. We got a bite. I'll be damned. A largemouth bass went for it, guys. Ah ha ha. Now see, I was fishing inward here before, and when I went on the outside, a largemouth went for it. So that one's pretty good. Not as good as the fat bodied, but they still went, well, I'll be damned. They are, I guess it is as good. At least it is here. Okay. This seems like a decent fish too. I don't think it's a bass though. It's a bowfin. I told you. Yeah, did I not tell you? Damn. I swear to goodness. Right here, that deep runner does. Maybe it's just because in the other locations it was too shallow. It is deeper here, so. Anyway, I think that's really all the ones that I can use at this point that are of the new lures. And so far, the only one that seems to have not have done well was the jerkbait. And now see, we've had these for a while. And I've already shown the bullfrog poppers how, you know, how they do. Well, looks like that's pretty much it. Nothing really unusual other than that. But yeah, you can definitely use a number of these here. The jerkbait, if there is a way to get it to work, let's just give it one more try at a different time. Let's see, what's the next peak here? It's 5 p.m. So we'll go ahead and advance to 5 p.m. We'll give it one more try in a good bass location. If we still don't get anything, then I am pretty certain that it's just a bit too big of a lure to get these guys. So right here is where I had some pretty good luck with that deep runner. Seems like the lift and drop just works best with this type of lure. One more try. I don't like to give up easily, guys. I'm sorry. It's just I want to see if there's a way to get these guys. Call it determination, call it bullheadedness, I don't know. But I am getting a great presentation. I'm getting like 3 on the lift and drop here. And nothing is going after it. Well, that is not an effective lure here. I mean, if somebody else has had any luck with it, you know, put it in the comments below, but I do not seem to have any luck with the jerkbaits here at Mudwater, and I'm pretty sure that it wouldn't be any more effective at Texas. Now, honestly, I don't think it would be any more effective at Emerald Lake either, but you know, we might give that a try a little bit here. I'm going to see if I can gather more of these baits and see if we can try some of the other ones out that are not holiday oriented, just so that you know for certain that it doesn't really make much difference whether it's holiday oriented or not. But anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed that first episode for the new year, 2020. And as I always say, guys, aim straight, cast far, and have fun. And I will see you later. Bye-bye.